poison is doing to your system. It's gonna kill you.
Romano.
Grandpa Hooker downed a gallon of coffee a day and made it to 94.
Try this. All I'm asking is try it. It's delicious. Just a little raw eggs, Romanian yogurt, crushed papaya, less than a mango juice. Secret of my success. And my virility.
Romano, when Grandpa did go at 94, 12 women wept at his grave, not including Grandma. Will you look what's coming down the boulevard?
Can you picture the inside? Fur on the walls, satin settee, quad sounds, those little... I can't believe it. Flat through the light. Still a good 7 minutes left on this break. It ain't fair.
Where is it written that life is fair? Put down your virility juice. Let's do our civic duty. And Romano.
Go easy around the turns. I don't want to spill one drop of this nice, sweet, delicious coffee.
No, let me have it. I want to see the inside of this love machine.
All right, but be careful.
Lost him.
Maybe the backup units can run him down.
Driver's gonna need an ambulance.
Hooker, take a look at this. It's enough firepower to start a war.
This stuff hits the street, there'll be a body count that won't stop.
Benedict.
Oh, yeah.
Barbary Homicide Division. Who are the officers on this?
Officer Romano and Sergeant Hooker, Lieutenant.
Hooker?
That's right.
Thomas J. Hooker?
You bet. He's right over there, sir.
Here. Look at that. It's coming up.
Hey, hot shot. Yeah, you, Hooker, you plug ugly.
I'm a son of a gun. Pete Benedict! The original Dirty Harry.
I heard that they got you back in the cavalry. You never were short on the guts.
No, it's my brain power I'm worried about. This is my partner, Vince Romano, Lieutenant Pete Benedict.
Lieutenant.
Romano.
Pete and I notched 5 years together in the 13th.
Your partner here was the best detective I ever worked with.
You on this one, Pete?
Special assignment, illegal irons. The computer readout says that the street trade has gone sky high.
No street cop needs a computer to tell him that. Even 10-year-olds are packing pieces.
Well, it looks like you guys have really stumbled onto a major wholesale delivery.
Enough merchandise to arm every punk in all 12 precincts this side of town.
Hold it. You ever seen this guy before?
I don't think so. It's not a face you'd forget easy.
Get a load of those tattoos. The guy's a walking gallery. You recognize the tattoo?
I've seen it somewhere, but I don't remember where.
Stupidest thing I ever heard. Running a red light. The streets were empty. Them guns shooting drove like there was a busload of kiddies on their way to Sunday school. That hardware was worth 200 G's on the street, man, and y'all ain't worth diddly spit. I got customers waiting all over town. The man is gonna be boiling mad. Press. Price is gonna double.
Secret, Lieutenant. I'd give a week's paycheck to be able to hold a tan like you got.
This is real. This is a genuine article.
You've been fishing without me, Pete.
You better believe I've been paying on this condo down in Baja. See, I got a year to go before I retire. So I go down there every weekend.
Gee, sounds great.
Why don't you find some time off? Give me a call. We'll go down together.
You got a customer.
Some collection.
Yeah, some of these were smuggled interstate, illegally imported, traded for drugs. Most of these were just stolen from citizens or from sporting goods stores, pawn shops.
Why go to all the trouble? Just about anybody can walk into a store and legally buy themselves a firearm.
Well, first of all, you have to be 18. And if the store owner is doing his job properly, you have to wait while you're checked out, at least in this state.
Federal law says you cannot own a gun legally if you have a record. Or you're a convicted felon. Or you're currently under investigation.
And that leaves a lot of kooks itching to get their hands on weapons they have no legal right to possess.
Any serial numbers yet?
No, sir. They're all the same. Numbers are filed off.
Wipes out its history, makes it almost impossible to trace.
But can't you bring the numbers back with acid etching?
Depends how much metal was taken off.
Where do you think I'm going to get the budget from? Or the manpower to even try acid etching for this arsenal? Excuse me, kid, I want to talk to your partner for a minute alone. Hooker, if you get any kind of light bulb as to where this arsenal came from or where it was going, that would help. You see, this is my last gig on the department. It's my swan song. I'd like to do it right.
You got it. I wish I could remember where I saw that tattoo before.
Let's put that in the computer, see what it spits out.
I'm free and clear all day Saturday and all night. What about you, Romano?
Saturday? Depends on it.
Excuse me.
Does duty call, Sarge?
It does, Officer Romano. It truly does.
I'm a bit confused. I was under the distinct impression that you and that little brunette who works the night shift for Captain Sheridan.
Lisa.
Lisa. I thought you and she were hot and heavy.
Lisa's fantastic. I love her. She's hot, peppery, tempestuous. But Vicky's wonderful. I love her too. She's sweet, cool, soothing. You know, if I had to pick, I'd be brokenhearted. Fortunately, things being the way they are.
Which way are things?
Vicky works days, Lisa the graveyard shift. Best of all possible worlds. And I'm never lonely.
From the vantage point of my advancing years, let me give you a tip. A man could buy himself a pack of trouble traveling the road you're on.
Hey, no way, not me. I'm concentrating hard just on these two. You know, before I got into the new training program and got confined to the academy barracks, I used to keep a half a dozen going at a time. Yeah. Now that was trouble.
All units in the vicinity at 4 Adam 30. A 211 in progress at 5th and Pine. 4 Adam 30, handle code 3.
4 Adam 30, roger.
A gun. I was so scared.
Which direction did he go?
He ran east toward Mission Street.
What'd he look like?
Short, black, wearing a brown jacket.
Oh, all right, thank you.
Hold it. Back up. Brown jacket, fits the description.
Go after him. I'll cut him off. This fellow wanted to kill me. He'd have pulled a trigger already. That right, son? You're not in real trouble yet. Not if you drop the gun. Try shooting it out, and you'll be dead. And being dead is as much trouble as there is. That's all right. It's okay. Man can cry if he wants to. I used to see that in the war every day. Just put the gun down, son. Just open your hand and let it drop. Let it drop.
Hooker, I can't believe you. This gun had a full load.
Another one. Numbers filed away. I don't want this kid. I want the lowlife who put the piece in his hands. Where'd you get the weapon, son?
Street.
From who?
A dude.
What dude?
What was his name?
Don't know any name. Guy comes around the block, asks me if I want to buy a piece.
Would you know him if you saw him again? If you saw a picture of him?
Don't know. Maybe.
Let's take a ride downtown.
Benedict.
Pete Hooker.
There's a young kid in a holding cell you want to talk to. The story's on my report. And another piece with a filed number.
Good, I'll be right over there.
Anything on the driver of the van?
Nobody's going to hear anything from him. He died in a crash of internal injuries.
Great.
Well, you know, Hooker,
nobody said this was gonna be easy.
No idea on him.
We're running his prints, but nothing so far.
What about the tattoo?
Nothing in the computer. But if you come up with something, let me know.
Right.
Hey, how's the food over there? I could eat a bear for lunch.
Lunch can wait, Romano. You see that little guy over there with the horse blanket jacket?
How could I miss him? That's some outfit.
Name is Banty, an industrious soul. Writes numbers for the sporting minded of the neighborhood. Banty! Hold it!
This ain't right, Hooker. You know, squad car cops don't roast out guys like me. You know, it's a different story when you were a gold badge.
What do we got here? A snitch who's a social snob?
I ain't a snitch.
Well, excuse me.
Check his pockets, Officer Romano.
I mean, sure, yeah, I did you a favor a couple of times, but that don't make me no snitch.
What we got here is lots of cash and lots of slips of paper with numbers on it.
Hey, come on, please. That's illegal search and seizure.
You're absolutely right. And I'll tell you what, I'll let bygones be bygones. We'll tear up those slips of paper and save us all a trip down to the station. I want a favor.
What kind of a favor?
I want you to buy me a gun.
What? You're a cop. You can get a hold of any kind of iron you want.
I want a street piece. One that has no history, can't be traced.
This is Hooker you can't get near. Hooker the uncorruptible. Hooker the Blue Knight. You got a scam going down or what?
Here's 50. Before I change my mind, book you for practice. I want you to buy me a gun, okay?
So long, George.
Officer Romano. Can I see you a minute? Well, what do you think?
I'm helping Lisa redecorate her apartment.
I thought the hand of the hip was macho.
Funny guy.
Must be convenient having your own decorator on the premises.
I don't know about Romano, but I think that these are unusual.
You think so?
Right. Exactly what I was going to say. I'll have to think it over, Lisa, and give you an answer later.
Well, how about Saturday? We could see how they look on the spot.
Saturday? I can't wait.
Saturday it is.
Sunday. Sunday would be better, if you don't mind.
Got it. See you later. Bye, Sergeant.
Bye, Lisa.
Bye.
Bye.
If that's the dark lady of the night shift, you do indeed have your hands full.
Yeah, she is fine, isn't she? Whatever it is I got, if we could bottle it, we'd make a fortune.
What you got, Junior, is a whole mess of trouble coming up.
I'm looking for Pete Benedict.
His office said he was here.
Oh, hello, Hooker. Yeah, he took some Saturday night specials up to the lab. He should be on his way back down by now.
Okay. Standing room only in a weapons room. How many weapons a year check through here?
This year we're pushing 10,000.
Growth industry.
Anything that comes along with a bust or is confiscated or isn't being held for evidence, we stash back there. When it gets too crowded, we ship them out to a foundry that melts them down for scrap.
Hey, Hooker! Slumming?
Benedict. Didn't hear anything from you on the weapons hall, so I thought I'd stop by and see what's shaking.
You didn't hear anything because there was nothing to tell. I picked out 36 of these at random, tried acid etching, came up with zero. That was the ground down too good.
What about the kid we busted?
I showed him pictures, drove him around the neighborhood, came up with zilch.
Now, maybe he's lying. Maybe he's afraid of a snitch jacket.
Maybe. Maybe not. Finally took him to juvenile. What's with you, Hooker? You miss detective work? You forget the dirt, the drudgery, the boredom?
Maybe I just don't like to see innocent people blown away because any punk with an itch can buy an under-the-table piece anytime he wants.
I hear you. But you just bring in whatever you got, like you did with the kid, and I'll follow through. Just like when we were partners, huh?
I got something going.
Oh, yeah? I'm listening.
No. When I'm ready, I'll let you know what I haul in.
No problem. Just promise you won't leave me out on any fun.
Mm-hmm.
hours late. Fanti's looking nervous.
Him and me both.
Now, wait a minute. Here comes a sweet-looking guy. Let's get him.
Picture gallery of the fine art of tattoo.
Remarkable coincidence, isn't it?
Remarkable.
A matchup.
Tattoo of the suspect, tattoo of the vandal.
Exactly.
What is it, some kind of devil?
Nope, I haven't seen one of these in years. That's why I couldn't remember it right away. It's a mythological figure. It's a symbol of the demons.
The who?
Big Bad Motorcycle Club. Broke up years ago.
Must have been before my time, Hooker.
Thanks, kid. I needed that.
These demons. Still a few around?
Well, there's an ex-demon. Lives near me. Corner of Eldridge and 11th. Runs a Mr. Fix-It shop. You could say he's been domesticated.
What are we waiting for?
Let's go.
Look, I ain't hung out with anyone from the demons for years. I'm on a straight and narrow now ever since I got married. You guys gotta park your car right in front of the house?
You worried about your civic image?
Hey, I'm in business here, and...
Waller! What's going on out there? What'd you do to bring the cops around?
Too late. See what you did?
It's all right, honey, but...
You've been doing anything! I'm gonna kill you!
Is that all you can tell us, Waller?
They're running a customizing shop called, ITNM someplace downtown. You know, they chop hogs. Make over vans and pick up stuff like that. How about you guys get out of here?
You fuzz, leave him alone. Whatever he's done, I'll straighten him out.
Thanks, ma'am. We were just asking directions.
Four Adam 30,
roger.
It's not likely there'd be two of them around.
Poor Bandy. The guy was just trying to help us.
He wasn't much of a citizen, but he was all right little guy. Dead because he kept his bargain with me. They used Bandy to send us a message. They're declaring war. Well, if it's war they want, it's war they're gonna get.
we get you all a brew from the cooler?
No, thanks. We're on duty. Maybe another time.
Ah, nothing's too good for the boys in blue. What can we do for you?
We're trying to trace a stolen van carrying an illegal gun load that crashed the other day.
I suppose you heard about that.
Oh, only what I read in the paper.
Now, you boys were members of the feared and mighty demons. Perhaps you can help me understand why two ex-demons were involved this past week in illegal weapon capers.
There's always somebody that's out after that big unlawful buck. Now, we ain't seen them dudes in years. And we don't know nothing about no illegal guns or illegal anything else because, you see, we're legit businessmen.
That's right.
Legal.
So you are. Look at their equipment, Officer Ramon.
Punches, drill presses, extruders, grinders. Just about every metal working machine available.
You don't mind if we look around, do you, Mom?
Oh, no, no. Seeing as how you got a warrant. You do got a warrant.
It's okay by me. If you want to play it by the book, I'm placing you all under arrest for violation of the state vehicle code 10750 and 10751.
Say what?
Altering, defacing, and replacing a vehicle ID number. Buying, selling, or possessing a vehicle with the IDs removed or defaced.
Exactly what happened to this vehicle here. For some reason, anybody altering a stolen vehicle, first thing they do is remove the ID number.
And come in here that way.
Add suspicion of receiving stolen property to the charges, Officer Romano.
Hey, man, this whole thing is a bunch of bullwash.
Attempting to provoke an officer with abusive language.
If you wasn't wearing that badge, I'd kick your teeth in.
At 4:15 to the list, Officer Romano. Challenging a uniformed officer to a fight.
I think I'm just gonna have to earn that.
Hold it!
Thank you, Officer Romano. At assault battery and resisting arrest of the charges, then send for a wife. Whereas we became suspicious and request to search the premises.
Whereas...
Oh, Romano.
Sergeant Hooker, there's a message from Lieutenant Benedict. He says he's on his way over and he wants you to wait for him. Says it's important. Hi, Vince. Surprise! They transferred me to day shift. Isn't that terrific?
Oh, yeah. That's wonderful, Lisa.
Now we won't have to meet at such weird hours. See you later, sweetie.
Yeah, later.
Hi, Lisa. Welcome to real life, the Sunshine Show.
Thank you.
You two know each other?
Oh, sure. We're old friends.
Same class at the academy.
And we've been dying to get together, but couldn't because of being on different schedules.
Well, now we'll have the chance.
Oh, great. I mean, great. Really, great.
In fact, we're out to lunch to celebrate Lisa's transfer and catch up on Girl Talk. Bye, Sergeant.
Bye, Vince.
Bye. Have a nice lunch.
Romano. Romano, justice in action.
How'd the lawyer and bondsman get here so fast? We just booked them.
I was hoping we'd have a couple of hours before they made bail.
For what?
I wanted to get a warrant and arrest seizure for the demon shop equipment. The lab can compare the grinding wheels with the work done on the gun hall for starters.
Sergeant Hooker. My clients have detailed your outrageous harassment. You're treading on civil rights, to say nothing of due process of law.
Counselor, all your weaseling and twisting of the law can't hide the fact that your innocent clients are guilty of buying, selling, and transporting illegal guns. Guns that are blowing the hell out of citizens' rights and the citizens themselves. And I'm gonna get your clients, Counselor, no matter what it takes.
Hooker, nice of you to drop by and see us. Step inside, Romano.
You might learn something.
I want to apologize for what I'm going to say. In fact, I don't even know how to start.
Just spit it out, Pete.
Hooker, we had a deal. You were going to bring me information. You were going to work with me. You were going to work through me. But no, you go off half-cocked. I've been clocking that demon body shop for months, hoping that they would lead me to the source. Now, you could have blown that.
Well, what about a warrant? What about a writ of seizure?
We don't have enough to go on. Now, it has to hold up in court. Now, what good is the arrest if it isn't clean and by the book?
Some citizens that are dead would now be alive. Look, I earn my pay on the streets. Not in the courtroom. You want to bring me up in charges, you go right ahead.
Wait a minute. Who's talking about charges? I want you to lay off this case.
Now look, I not only want you to lay off, I'm ordering you to lay off. Now, is that clearly understood by both of you? Officer Romano?
Yes, sir.
Hooker?
Understood. If there's nothing further, gentlemen, we're doing patrol. Dave!
Hooker. Took a lot of talking, but you got your warrants and you got your writ. Just keep my name out of it, huh?
Hooker, you're not gonna use those, are you? Captain Sheridan ordered us to lay off. Minutes, they'd be gone.
Hold it! We've got a warrant to search the premises. Keep them on ice, come on!
Where'd you get it, Mountain?
No.
Who's your connection?
No. I ain't gonna say nothing. I'd be as good as dead if I did.
Who's gonna pull the trigger?
I ain't gonna say nothing, man. Nothing.
You're blocking the garage with your car, Hooker. I can't get in.
Harvey was driving you.
His board meeting ran late. He asked me to meet him at the theater. The kids okay?
Yeah. They're fast asleep. Am I released now?
Yes, you're released. Thanks for babysitting.
What her ex-husband's for?
Excuse me. Hello? Yeah, he's here. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll tell him. I was Central Dispatch. They located Pete Benedict, said he had a message for you. He's on assignment and he'll talk to you tomorrow.
It was important.
Maybe what Pete's doing is important, too.
Yeah, you talk to Pete these days. All he wants is one glorious swan song to look back on while he sits on his boat in Mexico collecting his pension.
I hope to God you live long enough to do the same thing.
You let me down.
Put too much stock in the past, Hooker.
The good old days. I like the good old days. I like old cars. Old friendships.
Well, friendship means different things to different people. You'd walk through a flaming wall for a friend. You can't expect that in everybody.
Pete and I were partners. I have a right to expect a lot from people.
We were partners.
Do I expect too much from you?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know what happened. People just need different things, I guess.
I'm sorry I couldn't be everything you wanted me to be. I'm truly sorry.
There's no point in raking up old leaves.
No. What I don't mean are old leaves. I gotta go. Listen, do me a favor, will you? Call Romano, tell him to meet me at the precinct, and tell him to bring the kit.
Kit?
Yeah, the acid etching solution. Raise serial numbers on weapons after they've been filed away.
Hooker? The kids are counting on you for Saturday.
Saturday? I'll be there.
Hooker? I'm counting on you, too.
Vicky, run this number through the computer, see what you got. 367-934.
Thanks for staying late, Vicky. You and Lisa have a nice lunch?
Great, Romano. We found out we had all kinds of things in common.
Well, that's nice. Real nice.
Are you sure this is the number?
367-934.
According to records, this gun was originally stolen in a residential burglary. About 8 months ago, it was taken from an armed robber. So it was sent to property at headquarters.
How come this gun, confiscated by the department, hauled away and stored for safekeeping?
How come this gun is out on the streets again?
There you are. Destroyed just last month.
Last month? Isn't that kind of fast?
You could say that, especially when this indicates that it was checked in only a couple of weeks before that.
Well, it used to be every 3-4 months, but now we ship them out to the foundry every 30 days, just like clockwork. Took a shipment out this morning.
They're not destroying those guns. Somebody's switching them.
Sign for this, Sarge. All right, good enough.
Can you take me down that way?
Yes, sir.
Will you look at that?
Those two guys on the forklifts. They must be in on the operation. Can you lay that hook over there behind him?
Yes, sir.
Romano, when I get off, you come down the ladder and try and cut him off. Disappointed in you, Pete.
What do you want to do? You want to shoot it out with me? After all these years?
That's what I was thinking, Pete. After all these years.
Let me give it to you straight. Hooker, I am crowding 50 years of age. I've given my life to this department. And I've always played it on the square. All of a sudden, I realize that I'm facing retirement. I mean, I look around, I see the hustlers. I see the politicians, I see the crooked cops all cleaning up. And I gotta turn my back on it. The only thing I got to look forward to is a small potatoes pension. So when they offer me that job with the guns, I saw a chance for me to do something for myself. So what's the big deal? I'm selling guns. What's a few more guns added to the millions that are already floating around the streets?
I understand you, Pete. I even feel for you. But there's one thing that bothers me, and it bothers me real bad, about the condo and the sweet little boat. You've been buying them with blood. Sometimes the blood of your own fellow officers. Turn around. Put your hands behind you. With what you eat, Junior, I could die of starvation.
Freeze! Romano, you no good low-life rat. We talk things over at lunch. I mean everything.
Yeah, I can...
Not only are we good friends, Romano, but we share the same beliefs about the changing role in women, the feminine imperative, and all of that good stuff. We've both decided to free ourselves of the old confining role-playing and social pressures. And you're a nice, lively male specimen.
Yeah, but why don't we just...
So, this is what we've decided. Lisa gets you Tuesdays and Fridays. I get you Mondays and Thursdays. We alternate Wednesdays and weekends.
Hold on, I don't think I'm old enough to hear this kind of thing. Ladies, good day. Romano, good luck. You can return my car in the morning. If you can still drive, I'm taking the bus.